Rubab Mehdi, I'm a human rights defender. Well, we are here, we are protesting for the rights of the princesses. Here's a mother protesting for the justice of her daughters, who she hasn't seen for 13 plus years, who are living on one meal a day. And all I want to say is that until the time she gets justice, we will leave no stone unturned. We will go to the parliament, we will go to the United Nations, we will reach out to the human rights defenders. And anybody who knows the Muslim history or the history of the world knows that women movements, they cannot be seen by numbers, but the resilience. Here are women, we are considered weak, but we are standing in front of the most powerful people, who are considered to be the most powerful people in the world. And we have hope that we will get justice. I think, to be honest, the way I see it, these princesses are somebody who have spoken for the poverty in Saudi Arabia. They have spoken for the slums of Saudi Arabia. They have spoken for the people in Saudi Arabia. These are the princesses that could actually save the regime its reputation. These are the people that the regime should be proud of, rather than starving them. Well, I think, unfortunately, I do not want to get political, because for me this is purely a question of women rights, a mother seeking justice for her daughters. But yes, it is an example of the misogyny that we have in a lot of Muslim countries, unfortunately, and otherwise also. Wherever it exists, it should be challenged. Well, you see, this is, forget driving a car, here's a case where they're starving and they cannot even go out to shop for their food. So this is what we are concerned about. It's this issue of male guardianship. The way we see it, you know, God made, the way it is being interpreted, it is potentially making the women prisoners, and that is definitely not what anybody's intention was. Men are supposed to be supporters. They are not supposed to be starving their women.